Good morning to all of you. In the previous class, we started with solving some problems, those have taken from the VTU examination question papers, old question papers. We solved some 6 problems. In that, we have seen the problems to calculate overall heat transfer coefficient based on the outside surface area, length of the heat exchanger required, when the flow has been changed from parallel to counter flow, calculation of the surface area required, and percentage savings in length. Such problems we have taken, and one condensation problem we have taken, and we have taken a cross flow heat exchanger to evaluating the correction factor from the chart given in the heat and mass transfer data handbook. Now let us take the one more problem, that is the 7th problem, which has taken from the VTU July 2017 examination paper. Let me read the problem. The velocity of water flowing through a tube of 2.2 centimeter diameter is 2 meters per second. Steam condensing at 150 degrees Celsius on the outer surface of the tube heats the water from 15 degrees Celsius to 60 degrees Celsius over the length of the tube. Find the heat transfer coefficient and length of the tube, neglecting the tube side and steam side resistance. Take the following properties of water at mean temperature: density 990 kg per meter cube, K thermal conductivity 0.54118 watt per meter degree Celsius, specific heat 4.2 kilojoules per kg degree Kelvin, mu dynamic viscosity, it is 700 into 10 power minus 6 kg per meter second. Let me read the problem once again. The velocity of water flowing through a tube of 2.2 centimeter diameter is 2 meter per second. Steam condensing at 150 degrees Celsius on the outer surface of the tube heats the water from 15 degrees Celsius to 60 degrees Celsius over the length of the tube. Find the heat transfer coefficient and length of the tube, neglecting the tube side and steam side resistance. Take the following properties of water at mean temperature: density 990 kg per meter cube, thermal conductivity K 0.5418 watt per meter degree Celsius, CP 4.2 kilojoules per kg degree Celsius, mu 700 into 10 to power minus 6 kg meter second. Since here the temperature of a condensing steam remains constant, THI is equal to TH naught. Now LMTD equation. Now in this case, since the steam is condensing, either parallel flow or counter flow can be used, because whenever one of the fluid is phase change occurs, it is a condensation of a steam, so you will get the same delta Tm whether it is parallel flow or counter flow. Now and at the same time, in the previous problem we come across, the correction factor is not required whenever there is a phase change occurs. We know the LMTD equation for a counter flow heat exchanger is given by delta Tm is equal to into bracket delta T2 minus delta T1 divided by ln delta T2 by delta T1, which is equal to T into bracket TH0 minus TCI bracket over minus THI minus TC0 divided by ln TH0 minus TCI divided by THI minus TC0. This equation is available in any of the heat transfer book as well as in our data handbook, so you can use and calculate the delta Tm. Substituting all the temperature values, it is 150 minus 15 bracket over minus into bracket 150 minus 60 divided by ln 150 into bracket ln into bracket 150 minus 15 divided by 150 minus 60 bracket over. So upon calculation, delta Tm for a cross flow heat exchanger, it is we'll get 110.98 degrees Celsius. Now mass flow rate of water, we can calculate the continuity equation, you know, which we have studied in our fluid mechanics: density, cross sectional area into mean velocity. Density is given 990 and cross sectional area pi by 2 into this 2.2 into 10 power minus 2 whole square, that is the diameter of the pipe, into mean velocity is 2, which is given in the problem. It is 0.752 kg per second. Now heat transfer rate, Q is given by mass flow rate, specific heat into temperature difference, that is TC0 minus TCI. Upon substitution all the values, MC is 0.752, specific heat 4.18, temperature difference 45 minus 20. So we'll get the heat transfer rate as 142.25 kilowatts. Now Reynolds number for this situation is given by this equation. Reynolds number, RED, rho into mean velocity, D into mu. So upon substitution, 990 density, mean velocity 2, diameter 0.022. Mu value is given as 700 into 10 power minus 6. So we will get the Reynolds number as 62,228.57. Why you are doing all these Reynolds number, Prandtl number, and you are evaluating result number and H, finally you are calculating, because H value is not given. After calculation H value, then you are calculating the overall heat transfer coefficient. This procedure, you have come across already in your convection chapter to evaluate the convective heat transfer coefficient. In this case, convective heat transfer coefficient is not given. So hence we are evaluating the Reynolds number, Prandtl number, then taking the equation for the Nusselt number, and we are calculating the value of convective heat transfer coefficient. Now Prandtl number, PR is mu Cp by K. All the values are given here. It is 700 into 10 power minus 6. You know this mu value is Newton second per meter square. It is given in other unit, that is also same, one another same, substitute as it is. Cp 4.2 into 10 to power 3 specific heat converted to joules, and divided by K is 0.5418. So Prandtl number, it is 5.426. Nusselt number, it is a Dietz-Bolter equation which is available in your data handbook, because it is a heating or a cooling of a fluid. So depending upon our requirement, you have to use the Nusselt number. This equation is also available in your data handbook. 0.023 Red 0.8 into PR to the power 0.33. So we'll get Nusselt number as 274.97. And Nusselt number is also given by this equation. We know Nusselt number is equal to H average D by K. So it is H average we need to calculate. It into 0.022 divided by 0.5418, which is equal to 274.97. Nusselt number value will get this 274.97. Now average heat transfer coefficient, Nusselt number value we have 274.97, and equating this one with respect with H average D by K, we'll get the average heat transfer coefficient as 6771.7 watt per meter square degree Celsius. So we know heat transfer rate is also given by this equation. Q is equal to UAS delta TM. UAS delta TM. It is 142.5 U into 1000. Okay, Q is 142, we have calculated kilowatts converted to watts. U is, it is similar to that of the H here, because in the problem he has mentioned we have to neglect all the resistances. Then H is equal to overall heat transfer coefficient in this case. The same value it has been used here. AS substitute as it is, because we know we need to calculate the surface area of the heat exchanger, and delta TM we have calculated 110.98. So once we ignore all the resistances, then H is always equal to the overall heat transfer coefficient, since it is substituted as it is. So upon calculation, we will get the surface area of the heat exchanger AS equal to 0.1896 meter square. And surface area also, we know it is given by E is equal to pi DL. Pi, diameter of the tube as well as the length. So length works out to be around 2.74 meter. So that is the requirement, which was the requirement to calculate the length of the tube required for this problem. Here, as the H was not given, so we have followed the procedure, whatever we have followed, to calculate the convective transfer coefficient in convection chapter. Now let us take one more example, which has taken from the VTU January 2018 question paper. Let me read the problem. Hot engine oil, rather it is, to be cooled in a double pipe counter flow heat exchanger. The copper tube has a diameter of 2 cm with negligible thickness. The inner diameter of the outer tube is 3 cm. The water flows through the inner tube at a rate of 0.5 kg per second, and oil flows through the annular space at a rate of 0.5 kg per second. The average temperature of water and oil are 47 degrees Celsius and 80 degrees Celsius respectively. Calculate the overall heat transfer coefficient assuming the fully developed flow conditions. One condition imposed here, we have to assume the fully developed flow conditions. So this problem has taken from VTU January 2018 question paper. Let me read the problem once again. Hot engine oil is to be cooled in a double pipe counter flow heat exchanger. The copper tube has a diameter of 2 cm with negligible thickness. The inner diameter of the outer tube is 3 cm. The water flows through the inner tube at a rate of 0.5 kg per second and oil flows through the annular space at a rate of 0.8 kg per second. The average temperature of water and oil are 47 degrees Celsius and 80 degrees Celsius respectively. Calculate the overall heat transfer coefficient assuming the fully developed flow conditions. This is the problem given. Now let us calculate water side calculations separately as well as the oil side calculations separately. Now we need the overall heat transfer coefficient, let us calculate. First, water side calculations. Now, evaluate the properties of water at 47 degrees Celsius from the your data handbook. These are available at 47 degrees Celsius. If not, you go for the interpolation depending upon the requirement. Density is 989 kg per meter cube, K 0.637 watt per meter Kelvin, kinematic viscosity 0.59 into 10 power minus 6 meter square per second. It is unit is missing here. And PR is equal to 3.79. Now let us calculate the velocity of water using the continuity equation. We know continuity equation M is equal to rho cross sectional area into the velocity. So here mass flow rate is given 0.5. Density is given, so the cross sectional area is pi by 4 d square. So the velocity of water flowing is given by this value is 1.61 meters per second after calculation. Reynolds number, we know it is given by mean velocity diameter into kinematic viscosity. Mean velocity, just now we have calculated, it is 1.61 into 0.02 divided by kinematic viscosity 0.59 into 10 power minus 6. So Reynolds number so calculated is around 54,576.27 value. So that based on the Reynolds number, the flow is turbulent. Now let us use the Dittus-Boulter equation. This equation is available in the data handbook, heat and mass transfer data handbook, or any of the heat transfer textbook. It is available that nu is equal to 0.023 red to the power 0.8, pr to the power 0.4 is equal to 0.023. Reynolds number is 54,576.27 to the power 0.8, pr to the power 0.8. Since it is a heating, it is 0.4. 204. So the after upon calculation, Nusselt number is 214.42. Nusselt number is also given by this another equation, HID by K. Nusselt number, you are all familiar from convection chapter. So upon substitution, the inside heat transfer coefficient HI, substituting all the values, will get 7,690 watt per meter square Kelvin. Now let us do the oil side calculations. Properties of oil at 80 degrees Celsius. Density 852 kg per meter cube. K 138 watt per meter Kelvin. Kinematic viscosity 37.5 into 10 power minus 6 meter square per second. Prandtl number 490. The velocity of oil, again as usual using continuity equation, M by rho A. M is given 0.8, rho is 852. Since it is flowing through the annulus, so let us take it is pi by 4 into d naught square minus di square. It is 0.03 whole square minus 0.02 whole square. So the velocity of oil is 2.39 meters per second. Now, since oil is flowing through the annulus, let us calculate the hydraulic diameter. So this equation 4a by p, so that after substituting all the perimeter as well as the area, the hydraulic diameter works out to be d naught by di. So which is equal to 0.01 meter. Now let us calculate using Reynolds using this hydraulic diameter, Reynolds number, RED is equal to U naught hydraulic diameter by kinematic viscosity. Upon substitution, all the values, U naught is 2.39, hydraulic diameter 0.01 meter divided by kinematic viscosity 37.5 into 10 to the power minus 6 meter square per second. So this is 637.33. So now the flow is laminar. Assuming fully developed flow, so Nusselt number from the data handbook, depending upon this hydraulic diameter and Reynolds number, so it is given in the data handbook, it is nu is equal to 5.45, that is equal to h naught dh by k. So h naught is 75.21 watt per meter square Kelvin upon calculation. So outside heat transfer coefficient will get 75.21 watt per meter square Kelvin. we know overall heat transfer coefficient is 1 over given by this equation. Since a pooling factor and resistances are not given, 1 by U0 is equal to 1 over HI plus 1 over H0, which is equal to substitution upon HI and H0, 1 over 7690 plus 1 divided by 75.21. This U0 is 75.1 watt per meter square Kelvin. So overall heat transfer coefficient is 75.1 watt per meter square. Since HI is greater than H0, okay, since HI is greater than H0, so U0 is obviously equal to H0 outside heat transfer coefficient. So that is equal to 75. So in this case, the U0 is equal to H0, that is equal to 75.21 watt per meter square Kelvin. Now let us take one more problem. This problem has taken from VTU old question paper, July 2018. Let me read the problem. Water enters a counterflow heat exchanger at 15 degrees Celsius, flowing at the rate of 1300 kg per hour. It is heated by oil, into bracket Cp equal to 2000 joules per kg Kelvin, flowing at the rate of 550 kg per hour with an inlet temperature of 94 degrees Celsius, having an area of 1 meter square and overall heat transfer coefficient of 1075 watt per meter square Kelvin respectively. Determine the heat transfer at a degree temperature of water and oil. Now we need to calculate in this problem exit temperature of water and oil. Obviously we need to go for effectiveness method. Let me read the problem once again. Water enters a counterflow heat exchanger at 15 degrees Celsius, flowing at the rate of 1300 kg per hour. It is heated by oil, into bracket Cp equal to 2000 joules per kg Kelvin, flowing at the rate of 550 kg per hour with an inlet temperature of 94 degrees Celsius, having an area of 1 meter square and overall heat transfer coefficient of 1075 watt per meter square Kelvin respectively. Determine the heat transfer rate and exit temperature of water and oil. This problem has taken from VTU old question paper, July 2018 question paper. Now let us calculate the heat capacity rate of hot fluid. Heat capacity rate of hot fluid CH is given by this equation, MH into CPH. So that is equal to 550. It is a flow rate is given, kg per hour converted to per second, multiplied by Cp, it is 0.0305 kilowatt per Kelvin. Similarly, heat capacity rate of cold fluid is given by Cc equal to MC into CPC. So cold fluid flow rate is 1300 kg per hour converted to kg per second, so divided by 3600 into specific heat 4.18, it is 1.51. so among these two, heat capacity rate of hot fluid and heat capacity of cold fluid, the heat capacity rate of cold fluid is having maximum and hot fluid is having minimum value. Hence CH is C minimum in this case and CC is C max in this case. Heat capacity ratio capital C is now given by C minimum by C max, so it is 0.305 divided by 1.51 is equal to it is 0.20 C capacity ratio, heat capacity ratio. Now let us calculate the number of transfer units NTU, which is given by UAS by C minimum. U is 1075, area is 1 meter square, and C minimum is 0.035 kilowatt per Kelvin, so converted to watts joules per second per Kelvin. So multiplied by 1000, so it is works out to be 3.52. So now effectiveness value epsilon from the chat count for counterflow heat exchanger for C equal to 0.20 and NTU equal to 3.52. So it is works out to be 0.92. It is also possible to calculate the effectiveness equation given in the heat and mass transfer data handbook for counterflow heat exchanger. So only thing is, when you are using the graphical methods, so we have to be a bit careful. So you may go wrong while selecting the appropriate location in the graph. If anything go wrong, so this value changes. But with 5% error in most of the engineering applications, we can go with the graphical solution. Effectiveness expression, you know, it is given by this equation. Epsilon is equal to the CH into THI minus TH0 divided by C minimum into THI minus TCI. Substituting all the values, if you substitute all the values, we'll get effectiveness you have evaluated from the graph, it is 0.92. Inlet temperature is 94. TH0 as it is, because that is the required one, divided by C minimum and CH we have cancelled because CH is equal to C minimum, then divided by 94 minus 15. So exit temperature of hot fluid TH0 is equal to 21.32 degrees Celsius. So the effectiveness equation with cold fluid also we can write it is effect epsilon is equal to Cc into Tc naught minus Tci divided by C minimum into Thi minus Tci. Substituting all the values, effectiveness we have evaluated from the graph as 0.92. So Cc is 1.51 heat capacity ratio, rate of cold fluid. Then Tc naught, that is the required value that we need to calculate. Inlet temperature of cold fluid is minus 15. Substitute as it is, which is given in the problem. And C minimum is, it is 0.305. Then Thi, inlet temperature of hot fluid is 94. And inlet minus inlet temperature of cold fluid, it is 15. So upon calculation, we'll get exit temperature of cold fluid Tc naught is equal to 229.68 degrees Celsius. Now, heat transfer rate. Heat transfer rate is Q is equal to, you can use either heat gain equation or the heat loss equation. So now let us use the heat loss equation MHCPH into THI minus TH naught, that is equal to 0.305 into 1000 converted to watts, 94 minus 21.32. So the heat transfer rate works out to be 22.16 kilowatts. Let us take one more problem. Which this problem has taken from VTU old question paper, January 2019 question paper. 16.5 kg per second of the products at 650 degrees Celsius, into bracket Cp equal to 3.55 kilojoules per kg Kelvin. In a chemical plant, it's a product of a chemical plant, are to be used to heat 20.5 kg per second of the incoming fluid from 100 degrees Celsius. Into bracket Cp equal to 4.2 kilojoules per kg degree Celsius. If the overall heat transfer coefficient is 0.95 kilowatt per meter square degree Celsius. Listen here, in this problem it is overall heat transfer coefficient is given in terms of kilowatts, while calculation converted to watt per meter square degree Celsius, and the installed heat transfer surface is 44 meter square. Calculate the fluid outlet temperatures for the counterflow arrangement. Let me read the problem once again. 16.5 kg per second of the products at 650 degrees Celsius, into bracket Cp equal to 3.55 kilojoules per kg degree Celsius, in a chemical plant are to be used to heat 20.5 kg per second of the incoming fluid from 100 degrees Celsius, into bracket Cp equal to 4.2 kilojoules per kg degree Celsius. If the overall heat transfer coefficient is 0.95 kilowatt per meter square degree Celsius, and the installed heat transfer surface is 44 meter square, calculate the fluid outlet temperatures for the counterflow arrangement. This problem has taken from VTU old question paper, January 2019. Now let us calculate as that of the previous problem, heat capacity rate of the hot fluid. Ch is equal to MH into CPH. This equation we are all aware. 16.5 into 3.55. So it is 58.57 kilowatt per degree Celsius. Similarly, heat capacity rate of cold fluid, which is given by Cc equal to MC CPC equal to 20.5 into mass flow rate into specific heat. It is 86.1. Among these two, Ch and Cc, Cc is having maximum value. So let it be Cmax, and Ch is having minimum value. Hence it is C minimum value. Now heat capacity rate, it is given by C, capital C, which is equal to C minimum by C max, 58.57 divided by 86.1, that is equal to 0.68, and number of transfer units N2 equal to UAS by C minimum. So it is, upon calculation, N2 is equal to 0.714. Now you know, now let us calculate this problem. In the previous problems, we have evaluated the effectiveness value from the graphs. Now let us calculate this. It has been changed. This problem we can also evaluate the value from the graph, but now let us use that equation, effectiveness equation, which you have developed in the previous classes, and this equation is also available in the heat and mass transfer data handbook as well as in any heat transfer textbook. The effectiveness expression for counterflow heat exchanger is given by this equation. You all aware now, epsilon is equal to 1 minus exponential into bracket minus NTU into bracket minus 1 C bracket over divided by 1 minus capital C into exponential into bracket minus NTU into 1 minus C. Upon substitution, all the values, this NTU value you have calculated 0.714 and capital C as 1.68. It is substitution. Upon substitution, we will get the effectiveness value as 0.44. Now, effectiveness equation also given by this equation, you are all aware, this epsilon is equal to CH into THI minus TH0 divided by C minimum into THI minus TCI. Substituting all the values, effectiveness you have calculated using the effectiveness equation 0.44. 650 is the, in this case, CH equal to C minimum. So CH and C minimum, they are eliminated automatically. THI is 650 and TH0 we have to calculate, divided by 650 THI minus TCI is 100. So the exit temperature of hot fluid works out to be around 408 degrees Celsius. Similarly, one more effectiveness equation with respect to cold fluid heat writing using the actual heat transfer heat gain by the cold fluid effectiveness equation, we can write epsilon is equal to CC into bracket TC0 minus TCI divided by C minimum into THI minus TCI. Substituting all the values, effectiveness you have calculated is 0.44, CC is 86.1 and TC0 as it is, that is the requirement, minus TCI, it is 100 degrees Celsius, divided by C minimum is 58.57 and into bracket 650 minus 100. So upon calculation, exit temperature of cold fluid TC0 is equal to 264.62. It works out to be 260.62. So now let us take one more example. This problem has taken from VTU old question paper, July 2019. A heat exchanger has 17.5 meter square available for heat transfer. It is used for cooling oil at 200 degrees Celsius by using water available at 15 degrees Celsius. The mass flow rate and specific heat of oil are 10,000 kg per hour and 1.91 kilojoules per kg Kelvin, and mass flow rate and specific heat of water are 3,000 kg per hour and 4.187 kilojoules per kg Kelvin. Estimate the outlet temperatures of water and oil for parallel flow and counter flow arrangement by NTU method if the overall heat transfer coefficient is 300 watt per meter square Kelvin. Let me read the problem once again. A heat exchanger has 17.5 meter square available for heat transfer. It is used for cooling oil at 200 degrees Celsius by using water available at 15 degrees Celsius. The mass flow rate and specific heat of oil are 10,000 kg per hour and 1.91 kilojoules per kg Kelvin, and mass flow rate and specific heat of water are 3000 kg per hour and 4.187 kilojoules per kg Kelvin. Estimate the outlet temperatures of water and oil for parallel flow and counter flow arrangement by NTU method if the overall heat transfer coefficient is 300 watt per meter square Kelvin. This problem has taken from VTU old question paper, July 2019. So now let us do the calculations for the parallel flow heat exchanger. Heat capacity rate of hot fluid CH equal to MC CPS 10,000 divided by 3600 to convert it to kg per hour to kg per second into specific heat 1.91, it is 5.305 kilowatt per Kelvin. Heat capacity rate of cold fluid CC equal to MC CPC that is 3000 divided by 3600 into 4.187 which is equal to 3.49. Here in this case, among the heat capacity rate of hot and cold fluid is having minimum value and hot fluid is having maximum value. Hence, this is CC is C minimum and CH is C max. Heat capacity ratio C equal to C minimum by C max 3.49 divided by 5.305 is equal to 0.66. And number of transfer units N2 equal to UAS by C minimum. U is given 300, area is 17.5 divided by 3.49 to convert it to kilowatts to kilojoules, it is 1.5. Now, from the chart, the effectiveness value for C equal to 0.66 and NTU 1.5, it is from the parallel flow heat exchanger from the chart is 0.55. We know the effectiveness equation is given by epsilon is equal to CH into THI minus TH0 divided by C minimum into THI minus TCI. So upon you have evaluated this value from the graph as 0.55, you know this CH value 5.305, C minimum 3.49, 200 minus TH0 divided by 3.49 into 200 minus 15. So exit temperature of hot fluid equal to 133 degree Celsius upon calculation. Similarly, for the core fluid, effectiveness expression is given by epsilon is equal to CC into TC0 minus TCI divided by C minimum into THI minus TCI. Substituting all the values, we'll get it is effectiveness you have evaluated 0.55, TC not as it is, that you need to calculate, minus 15, bracket over, divided by 200 minus 15. CH is equal to C minimum, hence they are all those two are eliminated. So upon calculation, we'll get TC not is equal to 116.75 degrees Celsius. So now let us do the calculations for counterflow heat exchanger. And let us evaluate the value of effectiveness graph of counterflow heat exchanger for C equal to 0.66 and NT equal to 1.5. So it works out to be around 0.68. Now you can see we have discussed that the parallel flow heat exchanger effectiveness is 0.5, whereas this counterflow heat exchanger is 0.68. And we have also discussed during the previous classes that counterflow heat exchanger is having more effectiveness than that of the parallel flow. Now, effectiveness equation for with respect to hot fluid is given by effectiveness is equal to CH into THI minus TH not divided by C minimum into THI minus TCI. Upon substitution of all the values, this is effectiveness evaluated 0.68 from the graph. CH is 5.305 into 200 minus TH not divided by C minimum 3.49 into 200 minus 15. Upon calculation, TH not is 112.18. Just look at this TH not. Exit temperature is 133, whereas in this case it is 112. So the temperature has reduced, hence the effectiveness has increased. So effectiveness equation with respect to cold fluid, epsilon is given by CC into TC naught minus TCI divided by C minimum into THI minus TCI. Upon substitution of all the values, in this case CH is equal to C minimum, hence they are eliminated. TC naught minus 15 divided by 200 minus 15. So exit temperature of cold fluid, so it is TC naught is equal to 140.8 degrees Celsius. So you can also compare here in this case parallel flow it is 116 just, but the more heat is given to the cold fluid with respect to counter flow. So either way, by observing the exit temperatures or by looking at the effectiveness, we can see the counter flow heat exchanger is more effective than that of the parallel flow heat exchanger. Okay, now let me stop. We will continue in the next class.